What's up, guys? It's Brian again from Lake Hickory Scuba and Marina. If you can't tell by the video title down below, this video is going to be on logging dives, and there's several things that we're going to discuss. First of all, what is a dive? We're going to look at three different sources or three different definitions of a dive and kind of let you discuss it down below in the comments what you agree or disagree with as far as what a dive is. Number two, we're going to talk a little bit about logging dives. And should you be logging your dives? And then the last topic, of course, we're going to talk about what information should go in your dive log. So to start with, let's look at three different definitions here of what a dive is. Now, we are just simply going to be talking about scuba diving, not hard hat diving or surface supplied air diving or even free diving for that matter. We're specifically going to make this discussion on scuba diving alone. Now, according to Webster's Dictionary, they say that to engage in the sport or activity of swimming underwater using an air tank and a special breathing machine strapped to the body. Pretty clear cut to me. You're underwater, you're breathing, you have some type of special breathing machine, and it's strapped to your body. Let's look at Wikipedia real quick. It says a form of underwater diving where the diver uses a self-contained underwater breathing apparatus which is completely independent of surface supply to breathe underwater. That, to me, a little bit more clear cut. It talks about doing some type of underwater diving. You know, we got several types, free diving, scuba diving, hard hat diving, surface supply diving. But some type of underwater diving where a diver is using self-contained underwater breathing apparatus. There's the acronym for scuba, guys. Self-contained underwater breathing apparatus, which is completely independent of surface supply to breathe underwater. Once again, we're talking about scuba diving. We're not going to be talking about surface supplied air. So let's look at a third opinion real quick, or a third definition. And this actually comes from an instructor manual from one of the prominent training agencies. It says, to credit as a log dive for a course requirement, the dive takes place in open water, and specific information about a dive such as date, time, location, depth, profile, etc. is recorded. Now, we'll make a note there. It says for course requirements. So let's call this a training dive and not just a scuba dive. It's going to be a little bit different because it's clear cut what information must go in and what is logged here is, or what is the definition of that particular training dive is. Now, I am going to throw a little kicker in here. I'm going to give you a fourth definition, and this is my personal opinion of what a scuba dive is. So in Brian's personal opinion, it's anytime you are breathing some type of compressed gas, okay, under more than 1.0 atmospheres of pressure, and the risk of some type of barotrauma, such as pressure-related injuries, exist. To me, that is a scuba dive. So guys, there's four different definitions or four different opinions of what a scuba dive is. Let me know down below what your definition is and whether you agree with Webster's, Wikipedia, that training agency, or me, Brian. So now that we've kind of looked at four different definitions of what a scuba dive is, let's talk a little bit about should you be logging your dives. Now, there's a lot of good benefits to logging your dives, such as you can keep track of your sack rate. You can kind of keep track of what gear you use in different types of environments. So if you're diving cold water, you got a 7 mil, and you put in all that information about your weights, well, the next time you get in cold water with 7 mil, you can go back to that dive and know exactly what weight to wear. Or maybe that there's hazards on a particular dive, and if you go a while without diving that particular area, you can go back through your logbook and look at those hazards and know what to do when you're underwater, how to stay out of that area. You know, logging dive is also good if you are taking multiple classes and you got to have prerequisites. You know, having a logbook is really good as far as going back and showing those prerequisites. It does show an experience for you, for your instructors in the future, that you have experience doing certain things as you're taking certain classes. So there's a lot of good reasons of why you should log a dive. Let's talk a little bit about why you shouldn't log a dive. And this is a topic that doesn't really get discussed much. You know, if you're on the scuba forums, such as scubaboard.com, maybe here on YouTube, or even in your dive club or your local dive shop, most of the time they'll tell you, log a dive, always log a dive. But they never tell you when not to log a dive. And I think one of the reasons they don't really discuss that is because we really don't know when not to log a dive. Now, based off my definition alone, you should log any dive if you're breathing compressed gas, under more than 1.0 atmospheres where there's a chance of barotrauma. Now, based off that definition alone, to me, that would include confined water environments, even such as a swimming pool. Now, before any argument jumps up, I will go ahead and tell you, no, I do not log my pool dives. But, you know, we train students that you can get an air embolism, you can get decompression sickness, even in a swimming pool. And if that's the case and a barotrauma situation could occur, why couldn't you log that pool dive? So whether you decide to log your pool dives or not, it's completely up to you. I'm okay with it, but I will tell you personally, I do not log my pool dives. Now, let's continue on a little bit and let's talk about the third topic at hand. What information should go in the dive? Well, according to the training agency, for a training dive to be legitimate or to meet standards, it clearly states date, time, location, depth, profile, and etc. That etc. can be anything from what gear you used, how much weight you wore, what you saw, what your buddy's name was, stuff like that is very important to go in there. Let's talk a little bit about what information I personally put in my dive logs. And at the end of the video, I'll also talk a little bit about how I personally log dives. Well, some of the information I put is some of the most important information, such as depth and time. One of the things that divers have to worry about, of course, is our saturation of nitrogen. And the way that we determine that is how deep we are, how long we're there. Whether you use a dive computer or you use dive tables to plan your dive, putting that information in a logbook at the end, depth and time, will also help you or allow you to be able to determine how much nitrogen we saturated our body with. Same thing with the surface interval. If you log it in between your dives, you'll be able to calculate how much nitrogen you bled off, whether you're using a table or a computer, and how much residual nitrogen you have before you start that second or consecutive dive. So to me, depth and time are very, very important. Now, some other information that I like to put in there, of course, is starting air pressure and ending air pressure, because with that information, that gives me one of the variables I need for calculate my surface air consumption rate. Now, the other two variables there, of course, being depth and time, I've already got in there. So with air use, depth, and time, I can calculate my sac rate or surface air consumption rate. So to me, that is some of the most important information that must be in your dive log. Now, once again, this is just my opinion in the matter. Now, some other good information, of course, is what gear you used, what exposure system you used, how much weight you used. Some fun information, of course, would be geographical location. Was it freshwater, saltwater? What type of dive was it? Was it a wreck dive, drift dive, cave dive, stuff like that? But, you know, some other good information is, of course, your buddy's information, his name, what his certification level is, stuff like that is important as well. Just, in my opinion, it's not quite as important as depth, time, and air used, things like that. So, guys, that's just some of the information I personally like to put in a dive. Let me know down below in the comments what you put in your dive logs. Now, I'm going to throw a special little ending in here. I want to let you know personally how I log dives. For many, many years, I used to use those hard log books. I'd write in all that information. And then for several years, I would use a three-ring binder with just plain old paper. And I'd draw out my dive profiles and I'd write that. And I've not actually done that in probably 10 to 15 years. I have switched over to the digital age, whether I'm using a downloaded app on my phone or I'm using a training agency's app. You know, either one works good. It has all the fill-in-the-blank information that I need so I can put that in there, but that's still not quite how I log it today. I actually use technology to my advancement as far as logging dives. Basically, what I do is I take my dive computers, whether it's my wrist mount or my console computer, I plug it to my home computer, and I pre-download all that information. And it puts it into a profile for me that's basically a fill-in-the-blank that I don't even have to worry about. Then I can go back and re-study those profiles to get such things as sac rate or RMV rate. I can actually put it into a spreadsheet and see exactly how many cold water dives I did colder than, say, 60 degrees. I can see how many deep dives I did deeper than 60 feet. I can actually organize that information simply by downloading my computer's information into my home computers. So guys, I'll go ahead and tell you, I do not personally log dives on paper anymore. All my stuff's done digitally. You know, when you log dives, we talked a little bit earlier about why you should log a dive, what's the good purposes in it, whether it's for future training classes, you can show experience. You know, maybe you meet that buddy out there that, you know, he's an Insta buddy and you want to learn more about him. Well, you can validate his stories, if you will, or his training experience by simply going through his logbook. Instructors do it all the time when we take on a new student. We can validate simply by their logbook. Now, yeah, we do have to take them at their word, but for training purposes, a lot of times in their student profiles, we must have some type of documentation, even if it's taking their logbook, picking out a dive, scanning it, and putting it in their student folder. Sometimes that's what we have to do to validate their experience level. Well, for me, I just keep a digital download. It's based in a spreadsheet profile, and it's downloaded from my computer. That's personally how I log dives. How you log it is going to be completely up to you. What dives you log is going to be completely up to you. The definition of a dive, once again, it's going to be completely up to you. But guys, let me know. I want this to be a very big discussion. I want to see a lot of comments down below. Comment to me, comment to each other. If you want to shoot a response video to this, definitely tag me in it because I want to know what you consider a dive, should you log that dive, and what information you put in the dive itself. Guys, I really appreciate you watching this video. If you got any questions, comments, or concerns, put it down below. If you like this video, smash that like button for me. But guys, as always, make sure you follow us on Instagram and Twitter, like us on Facebook, pin us on Pinterest, subscribe to us here on YouTube, and as always, guys, we appreciate your business.